Wild Card Custom Paint Pimp Sunday, 7:50. We interrupt this broadcast to clear a few things up, people. People were saying my last video was a little dark. Medieval. Okay. I need to clarify something. I've been hit one too many times. People laid their hands on me. It ain't happen no more. That's why I get like I do when somebody confronts me. It's kind of like this. Got an email or two saying that's kind of dark, medieval, whatever. And per se that they wouldn't be like that. Let me put you in this scenario. You come home from wherever. You walk in your bedroom or anywhere in your house, and there's somebody ready to do bodily harm to your wife, your kids, or your loved ones. And you're not going to go medieval on them? Really? I'm not a violent man. But do you get my point now? Okay. I'm glad we got that cleared up. I went to regular program. I was thinking about this today. My youngest boy, Nicky, he must have been about four or five, and he made this for me. And the reason it's funny is because it says Mr. Fixer. And I know my boy is real young, and I kept it. And I guess what makes it funny is back then, he even knew I was Mr. Fixer. Here's the thing that I just noticed. This is the front. It's like a little wallet. Okay, this blows me away because he reminds you a lot of me. This is the front, this is the back. Look how he spelled everything backwards, as if you could see through it. See what I mean? He spelled everything backwards. I don't know why he did that. Maybe because he feels that things have to be perfect. I hope I didn't shove that down his throat. But anyway, I'll show you what I did today and what I noticed. Well, I did lie to you guys. I did work on the vet yesterday for a couple hours. I learned patience yesterday. This windshield was installed, oh, I don't know. It had only been in there for 799 miles. But look at the... Look how thick that stuff was that I had to cut through. Let me get on the other side of the light. It took forever. Really? That stuff was pretty thick. To give you a look at how thick that stuff was. And it wasn't the butyl, it was that what was happening is when I stuck a knife through and it was hot, it would get some, but then I couldn't get it off in the corners where it's curved. So I took a hacksaw blade, and every time I cut this stuff, it's hard, so it would ball up and get caught, and I could hear the glass go, it'd make a noise and it freaked me out. So what I did is I learned to put some oil on it to clean the teeth on the hacksaw with a vice grip. I did it that, it took me 3 hours to do. That's some hardcore butyl. That stuff was in there quarter inch at least. I'm pretty proud that I got that out. I am. Pretty much had to take the steering column out. I swear to God, to get that clutch pedal out and to get that nut out right there, you had to lay on your back and be triple jointed, hang upside down from a tree with one leg to get it off. It was out of control. I don't know how they put it together, but they do. See, I had water. I don't know how, because floor pans in the bed are actually is metal. It's not all the way through and I can fix them, but I'm not fixing his body. And you guys know that. But I did get the wire harness out. I don't think I need the heating system, but just in case. Just in case, you know. Only thing left is in here is this when you have people have a vet know that you don't have to turn the lights out, you can just pull this vacuum and turn the headlights up and down because it's built off a canister. Looks like a coffee can. That's how the headlights operate. But anyway, in here all I have to do is drop the shifter, drop the parking brake, and as long as it took me to do this, I would really like to save this window because I got the etching on it, but the other vet does have a window, and I'm really debating. This has got more curvature right here. Man, I think, I don't know. I think I'll just redo the etching on the other one. Because I'm not keeping the vet. Want to, but I ain't going to. Because I need to finance the Corvette. This is what I've noticed. I'm anxious to see what I jack it up and swap the rear ends out. What's it look like underneath? But this, I'm glad I swapped all this out. Because you see where the roll bar was? And when I pulled it out, I didn't bend it or reef it. But look where the crack was. Right there. This is what I noticed today too. And I would have never known if I wouldn't have pulled this vet apart. If I would have welded the frame, here goes the magical lights again. Here we go. That had to happen during the crash. And I never knew it was there. And the only way that could happen is, I don't know. The engine must be pushed up. I know you can't get a good shot, but the engine must be pushed up against there or pushed up there for a minute or something. I'm not sure. And I can imagine if I wouldn't have had the roll bar in it, how much more impact this body would have took. Like I said, you could see right here where the roll bar used to be with the fiberglass. You know, so the water wouldn't get in. But look at the crack. And that wasn't from me reefing on the roll bar either, because I took it out nice. Because I didn't want to, you know, I didn't want to tear it up because I wanted to put it in its vet. This car took a hell of a flight. That's all I can say. That was surprising. I'm thinking, now it makes it feel good that I'm tearing this all apart and not trying to rebuild this. Last couple days I've been kind of, you know, thinking, am I doing right? Once I seen that, nah, even though I'm not keeping it, that's not good. If you'd had to fix it, that's fine. And I don't have a door remover. So what I did is, I took the four bolts off, the three bolts off, and left that bolt on, shut the door so it latched, reached in there, impacted the bolt off, and then so it kind of held, it slid down a little bit. I'm not saying the paint didn't get damaged, but I'm going to repaint it. And then I unlashed and carried it. Corvette doors are kind of heavy. And I'm sure I'm not telling you guys anything new. A friend of mine wanted to know how well this Eastwood encapsulator, I showed you a picture just here of the vet windshield. This is, even though it's a 1K, they actually held pretty good. Can you see how much butyl they, or not butyl, because butyl is easy to get off. I know what butyl is because I used to encapsulate windows. But this is that red, not silicone, but whatever they use professionally. Man, I think he put enough in there. And it took forever and ever to get it out. But I had to have this windshield. I didn't want to buy another windshield. Because when I had this windshield put in, maybe I got the insurance company got robbed, but Hagerty paid for a new windshield before it got crashed. And you have to replace these two rubber strips with metal, and they make you buy them. It was $750 for the windshield. Is that out of control in price? Yes, it is. But when it comes to a vet, man, it's weird. Like I was telling somebody, this is just a small block Chevy. It's not a long water pump. It's not a short water pump. It's a Corvette water pump. And see how close it is? There is no tolerance. Neither one will fit. You know why it won't fit? Because that snub nose right there, that pulley will be, that this right here, it'll be sloppy. That's what I found out. I wouldn't believe it, but I went through it. And you got to buy a Corvette water pump because I replaced that. I can't honestly remember how much it paid for it, but I know it wasn't cheap. And I thought about it, yeah, but I won't do it because it's just wrong. Because I was talking to a buddy of mine and he said, you know, the other vet I got is 80, and this is 80, and this has got a clean title because I never let the insurance company take it. So I kept title and it's clean. That's the VIN number. That's the VIN number. All it is two pop rivets, and I could put another vet and claim, because this motor does match this car. I know it does. When I pull this motor out and put in the other vet, it's an 80. I could do that and probably get more money because it's numbers matching, because some people like numbers matching car. Will I do that? No. You know why I don't do, I think naughty things. You know why I don't do it? I wouldn't want it to happen to me. That is the bottom line. It's not because I'm super nice guy or super honest. It comes down to, would I want somebody to do that to me? And the answer is no. Because then I'm going to veer off to something else. That's what makes me nervous. The wire harness. It's about all I did today. I think that stuff was. Talking about being nervous, cutting that out? Wow. It's good that in, one thing's good about living in the north, we have basements, because in the south, I guess the ground is so hard that you can't dig down and have a basement. See, we got basement, and that's going to be a new Corvette storage parts for a month or two. Oh, here's another reason why I won't swap the VIN numbers. It's not because I'm doing this video, because if I was going to do that, I wouldn't say that. Here's Mama's Firebird. It's, I think it's locked. It's a 68, you could tell 68 only had that. There's a guy out there building a 68 Firebird and you wanna check Mama's. Why does Mama lock it? I don't know, probably habit. Let me see if this side's locked. Ah. Got a velvet interior, it's got air conditioning, it's got the 160 mile speedometer. I put the ratchet shift in. Buckets, I think it has the deluxe door panels, I'm not sure. 68 only didn't have the vent windows. I know that. I'll show you something. You see where it says 91,475 miles? Okay. See, this was, ouch. We looked at a lot of Firebirds. My wife didn't want a Camaro, she wanted a Firebird. I like Camaros, but anyway. This is the last one we looked at. We looked at a lot of them for like $8,000, $9,000. And you would think you could get a nice car for $8,000, $9,000. This is probably even, I don't know, 6 years ago. Yeah, commercial break. Kinda, you know, it wasn't right. I'll make the story quick. We just did a lot of Firebirds. Went out of state every weekend because Mama wanted a Firebird, and you know, let's go get one. Don't live forever, you know. Anyway, she always liked the humps in the back of the wheel well. We seen it a Firebird in the book, and she asked me what it was. She liked the humps. Excuse me. Anyway, we looked at a lot of them, 8,000, 9,000. There's a lot of stories about different cars or whatever, but I'm not even gonna go there today. Went and looked at that one because it had the Ram air hood, had the wing. It was a 400. Okay. Guy wanted 12.5. And this is no joke. I don't know this. Up north, down south, Michigan, I don't know. Anyway, went and looked at it. This dude had a long driveway. It was huge. This is sounds like it's far-fetched, but it's not. His house is way over here. It was huge. I'm talking huge. And he had a garage. It was, I don't know, 100 by 60. It was huge. He had a sink, everything. He actually, I swear, he had snowmobiles. And he was selling that. He had a Roadrunner. He was 67 Roadrunner or something, square body style. He thought it was all that. It was beautiful. He had a few other cars. But he had warehouse racks in the corner. And he had a forklift where he stored a couple snowmobiles of his. That's how much money he had. I kid you not. Anyway, I can see how he got his money. Because when we called him, he said it was original miles, original motor. Okay, there's no reason not to believe him, because he wanted 12.5. Okay, I get it home. It does have a 400 triple transmission. Okay, it does have that. It's got a 72 or 73 GTO motor in it. It does have 325 horse. I said 324 in the other video, but it was 325. At least it has a horsepower close to compatible with what a 68 Firebird would have. But the guy lied. He said that his numbers matching. He lied. And he was well-to-do. Maybe that's how he got his money. I don't know. And he said it was original miles. You know what? Yeah. The speedo works. Something about the speedometer, the miles don't rotate over and over. Just click. When it gets over to a new mile, it just clicks. There's something in there. But anyway, That was kind of, she's still happy with the car, but that was wrong. And I don't want bad things to happen to me, so I don't do bad things. It's like, what if I found a guy that won a Corvette? Like, I went to the New York to get a 4-speed because I wanted a 4-speed. What if I find a guy that wants numbers matching car? Some old guys like that. Me, it doesn't matter because I'm modifying it anyway. But, and then he bought it because it was numbers matching and other things, and he gets it home and it's not number matching. And that kind of, he still likes the car, but he's not so happy. Maybe he wouldn't even come and look at it. I'd rather not have him buy it than advertise something that's not what it is. It's like when I've sold cars before, if they ask me if it has bodywork in it, I say, what car hasn't? Then if they pursue it again, the question, I'll show them right where it's at. I can never be a used car salesman because you know how they are, you know. But ain't got nothing against no used car salesman. It's just a joke. Don't get all pissy, people. Peace of mind, peace of property, peace of oneself, peace of pussy, peace of something, motherfucker. I hope. Slow SRT made a video. Like to see what he's doing, what his life is like. Don't really have much else to say. Some videos I'm still not getting, and I have to search them because they don't tell me when a new video is loaded. I don't know why. Anyway, I'm rambling. I'm gonna go on and let you. Tomorrow's the 7th day, and I should sand this primer down, and I'm not going to. I've gotten so far on that bat. Maybe I'll change my mind tomorrow, but I got so far on that bat that all I have to really do is pull the motor, pull the trans, pull some engine parts off, pull that bat out, bring it to my parents' house, bring the red one back,
And then that my parents also dropped that Marantz, because it's got 373 gears in it with new pin and gear in it with new clutch plates that Port City Racing did. That's another story, but I'm not even going to go there. It would be nice. And then I got to take the stock Marantz, I think it's a 308 out of the tan vet, and put it in there. There's not much left to the vet. But I was thinking, I went to quite a few years ago, Chicago Vet Fest. They charge $25 for parking. But anyway, that's why I don't go no more. Anyway, I remember looking at a rear end. They say it was rebuilt. I don't know. They wanted $500. This was like 6 years ago for a Corvette rear end, because it's got the spring this way instead of this way. People like to put it in old cars. But I'm thinking the back quarters. I had the price quarters, even though that one's got a big rip in it. The quarters, the back window, and the rear end's got to be worth. I'd probably junk it out for $300. I'm not gonna. I'll let it rust right into the ground first. I will. I just don't give things away. Like that Ranger, $99, I gave it away. I ain't giving stuff away no more. I bet you I can get. It's the right person might have to set on it, and I will. It don't matter to me. I bet you I can get a G-note out of it. But I could be wrong. Enjoy your evening.
Peace.